Sona DJ Nelvianor. So hello people, aside from Department of Labor and the Antioch Police Department, now I'm starting a new court case. Now if there's an identity fraud issue going on in your life, I would suggest not only to have fingerprints but also your dental history documented at a dentist. Here in America, you get free dental and medical, so there should be no reason for you not to be able to see a dentist and get your teeth and everything documented and your fingerprints. So your fingerprints can be done through a government agency. So when anything happens or you lose your things and, you know, you're wandering around or whatever the case may be, they'll be able to find you in the database through your fingerprints. And also your dental records will solidify you as that specific person, okay? So if you're dealing with identity fraud, that is one way of dealing with it. A third way of dealing with identity fraud is court system. So I'm in the two court systems in two different counties. Now I'm going to head out and do a third, which would be, again, bringing back my domestic violence court case to light. And just know that if once they're found guilty, there is a history in your dental record showing that you would need surgery every specific amount of years, then they shouldn't deny you, but you have to prove that they were found guilty. So the court case will be held at the police station. The main police station will have a record of the file that this person was found guilty for this specific crime and had to pay restitution. Restitution is basically when you break a bone, that's considered a felony. Misdemeanor is basically a first-time offender, so it's like a slap in the hand. Well, you know, even though it was supposed to be a felony case, I didn't die, so it became a misdemeanor. He had a good lawyer, a family friend. So it's good to know people with power. So what you need to do is go to the small claims court. Small claims is civilized court, okay? Know the difference between primitive and civilized. So civil court is small claims. What you need to do is find out where he was found guilty. Was he found guilty in family court? Was he found guilty in criminal court? Those are the two court cases. So he was found guilty under criminal court. So you got to type up a letter explaining why you believe he should pay you for the dental surgery. It was something that he caused. It was his decision. Doesn't matter how the argument started. Doesn't matter how we ended up altercating during my second pregnancy. It was a second planned pregnancy, second engagement. I did not want to go through with the pregnancy, but he decided, no, we're getting married. Let's follow through with the pregnancy. So for you who's involved in my life, know that he told me to have our baby because we were getting married, and this was in the fourth year of our engagement, okay? So whatever lies he may fed you, I'm clarifying them for you because everyone knows I have an abortion. I don't hold down a man by pregnancy. It's not going to happen. It's not reality, okay? You can fool yourself believing that, but if you're not engaged, it doesn't exist, okay? You're guilty. So anyway, and if you're having sex before marriage, you're guilty, okay? So don't use religion like, oh, I'm religious. No, you should have had an abortion because you were active knowing that you are religious. That's a sin in itself also. So I understand. Anyway, small claims court, got the letter. Even though the surgery cost $4,500, round it off to $5,000, and then you can send him a letter asking him to pay $2,500, which is half of the surgery, because it takes two people for an argument. So half of the surgery would be $2,500, which is $2,500. And again, make sure that you have everything needed. You know where they live. You know where he works. You can have the sheriff serve the defendant. You're the plaintiff. Remember, the complainer is the plaintiff. Complain, plaintiff. And then the defendant is, he's going to have to defend himself. So remember that difference also in a small claims or any type of court setting. It'll always be the complainer and the defendant. And I'm the complainer, the plaintiff, who has lifetime damage done to my face. Not only my nose broken, but also my jaw. But, you know, those are lessons learned. He is the second fiancé who punched me on my left jaw. But I didn't know he was going to get that way for his bitch. That's the other woman that was involved and that he has been with for all these years, and I have them for premeditated murder now because they never left me alone. That's the second reason that I'm reporting both of them to the court system. Expose them.